friends, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in today's biology session, we are going to learn about the new lesson, that is lesson number 7, conservation of plants and animals. Okay, what we are going to discuss, that is conservation of plants and animals. So the first question I am going to ask you about, is it necessary to conserve the plants and animals? What you will give the answer? Yes, obviously it is very very important to conserve the plants and animals, okay. But the next question is that why we have to conserve the plants and animals? Why we have to take care of the plants and animals, okay? Because so as we know, there are the so many species were present on the earth. For example, in that we can say that some species can get extinct. Extinct means what? They get vanished from the earth. For example, we can say that dodo was there, as we can say dinosaurs. We were just listening about the dinosaurs, but no one has up till now has seen the dinosaurs in a real life, okay? So it means what? These are the certain species which were present on the earth, but because of the certain reasons that all the species get vanished, get extinct from the earth, okay? But now also the earth is having so many different species of the animals and the plants, and among that there are the certain species of the plants and animals are there, they are also on the way of the extinction, okay? So for that purpose, to protect them, to preserve them, we have to conserve the plants and animals, okay? And it is very important, if we conserve the plants, then obviously we will conserve the animals, because the most of the animals are living on the tree are their habitat. They are living, for example, we can say the birds. Birds are making the nest on the plants or the trees. Some arboreal animals are there, for example, monkeys, apes are there. They are also living on the trees. So in this way, if we make or if we preserve the forest or the trees or the plants, then on the other hand, we can conserve the animals also, okay? So see here, there are the different causes are there which causes the loss of the plants and animals. And among that, the first one cause is what? Deforestation, which is a very important cause for the decreasing different species from the earth. That is what? Deforestation and its causes. So let's see what is meant by deforestation. So as we know, cutting down of the trees on a large scale, okay, the cutting down of the trees on a large scale is called as what? Deforestation, or we can say that clearing of the forest and using that land for the other purposes, okay. We are cutting down the trees on a large scale, we are making their developments, we are developing the building, certain types of the industries, or we can use that crop for the cultivations, to take the agriculture products, to get some economical things from that products, okay. So in this way, there are the certain reasons are there. For that reasons, we are clearing the lands and we are cutting the trees on a large scale, then it is called as what? Deforestation, okay. So there are the certain reasons for that purpose we are cutting the trees. That is, all trees in the forest are cut for, because of which reasons there are the exactly cutting of the trees are takes place. So the first one we will discuss about the procuring land for cultivation. Means clearing the land, we are cutting the trees to do the different types of the cultivations. Now cultivations means what? To take the different agriculture crop, and from that we will get the benefit as a economically we will get some money. Next one is that building houses and factories. As we know, in our India, the population is growing on very rapidly. The graph of the population is going on up and up, and it is very important to provide the basic needs for each and every living beings, or for each and every human being. And which are the basic needs? Food, shelter and clothes. So to provide them shelter, to provide them house, we have to make the certain buildings, houses or the societies, and for that purposes we are cutting the trees. Next one is that, or simply we can say that making furniture or using wood as a fuel, okay. So as we know, most of the cutting of the trees are, or the most of the furniture in our house is made up of what? Wood. And from where we are getting that wood? Obviously from the plants. So we are cutting the plants sometimes to make the furniture, and also in the village area or in the rural area, the people are cutting the trees to use the wood as a fuel. Okay, so these are the certain reasons for that the forests are cut. Next one, if there is a deforestation, then it causes what? So from this next discussion, we are going to find out the reason for this same question. Now we will discuss about what consequences of deforestation. Consequences means deforestation causes which thing, which are the problems which provided because of what? Deforestation, which causes due to the deforestation. So from these consequences, first one we are going to discuss, that is first one what? Increase the temperature and pollution level, very important. So if there are the less number of the trees, then obviously the carbon dioxide will get increase in the atmosphere. And as we know, the carbon dioxide is which gas? Greenhouse gas, okay. So because of that, what happens? The temperature will get increased because the less trees are there to absorb the carbon dioxide. And also very important, because of the increase in the temperature or increase in the carbon dioxide, it also causes what? Pollution. So the pollution will also get increased. Okay. Next one, increase the level of CO2. Okay. So see, if the we are the human beings, as we know, with the help of the respiration, we are throwing out the carbon dioxide gas out, and we are taking inside the oxygen. Okay. So if there are the less number of the trees, the very important thing is that what? We will not get the enough amount of the oxygen for the breathing process, or for the next one, that is respiration process. And whatever the carbon dioxide gas we will throw out, no one is there to absorb that carbon dioxide gas, and which causes what? Increase in the levels of CO2. Okay. Next one, groundwater level scale lowered. Okay, if there are the less number of the trees, then the land become open land, then the water will not go very or the less amount of the water will go underground, and that is the reason the water or the underground water level course becomes lower and lower, because only some amount of the waters are going inside the land, or the seepage of the water is what? Less. Okay. Next one, disturb the balance. And because of all these reasons, we can say obviously there is a disturbance of the balance in the nature. Rainfall and the fertility of the soil decreases, very important. As we know, the plants also help for the respiration, also helps for the rainfall. How does it helps for the rainfall? Because as we know, the plants are performing the transpiration process. Transpiration process means what? Removing out or the throwing out the excessive water in the form of water vapor. So which helps to form a more amount of the rainfall. So if the number of the plants are more, then the rate of transpiration is more, and then the rainfall is also more. But now see the opposite side. If the less number of the trees are there, then the rate of transpiration is also less, and which causes the less rainfall. Okay. Next one is there, the fertility of the soil is also decreased. So if there are the fewer trees are there, then the soil becomes open, and the uppermost layer, which is a very fertile layer of the soil, it get washed out with the rain water, or it get washed out, it get blown out with the air, and the soils become what? Infertile, or we can say the soil will decrease its fertility. Okay. Next one, floods and droughts. Okay. So as we know, floods means what? Heavy rainfall for the longer period of the time, it causes what? Floods. So if there are the infertile lands are there, then that lands will cannot absorb the water. Okay, that lands will cannot absorb the maximum water, and because of that reason, there is a less absorption of the water in the ground. It causes what? Floods. Okay, the water level in the rivers get rises, which causes what? Floods. Opposite to that, that is what? Drought. If there is a very less rainfall because of the less number of the trees, then it causes what? Droughts. And the droughts makes the land also decreases the fertility of the soil also. Next one, global warming. It gives rise to the global warming. Now what is mean by the global warming? Now imagine if you are sitting in the car, okay, and the car is standing in the sunlight. Then what will happen? And all the windows of the cars are closed. Then after some time, we are feeling suffocation or suffocated. Okay? Why? Because the car's window allows the heat to come inside, but that heat cannot go outside, and that effect is only called as what? Global warming. Okay, it is called as what? Global warming. So the deforestation also causes what? Global warming. So from the deforestation, what happens? Increases the level of the CO2. That CO2 is what? Greenhouse gas. That CO2 gives the entry of the sunlight to come inside, but it doesn't use the exit, which increases the temperature, and for that only we are calling as what? Global warming. Okay. So day by day, year by year, century by century, the global warming is getting increasing only. Okay. Next one, soil erosion, that we have already discussed. Because of the fevered trees, the uppermost fertile layer of the soil is get blown with the water, also get washed with the water, blown with the air, and it makes the soil erosion. It causes the soil erosion. Fertile land gets converted into desert. It is called desertification. Okay, so because of the fevered trees, okay, what happens? Some physical properties of the soil is get changed. How? Because the soil is uncovered, so that soil can easily blow with the air, also it can easily wash with the rain water, and the fertile uppermost layer of the soil is get vanished, and now the soil is become what? Infertile, which is not good for growing any types of the crops, and that type of the landing is called as what? Desertification of the land. Okay, so the deforestation also causes the desertification of land. And the last one, infiltration rate reduced. Okay, so less number of the trees are there, and that is the reason the soil cannot absorb the more amount of the water, because the uppermost layer, which is very fertile, which has the more ability to absorb the water, it already vanished. Okay, it already removed with the help of the soil erosion, and now the soil has doesn't that much capacity to absorb the more amount of the water, which is only called as what? Infiltration rate reduced. Okay, so all these are the consequences, all these are the certain causes which cause due to the deforestation. Okay, so this is all about today we have discussed about the deforestation and its causes. So here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.